What was that?
One of those jerks again.
You can say that again.
I'd say he's earned himself a caution, right?
He sure did. Turn on the siren and let's go.
Waiting in the rec room. He's a cadet. I want you to take him with you and involve him in your investigation so he can get an idea of what your work is about.
Aw, Chief, do we have to? Can't Bonrad and Herzberger take him?
Bonrad's on leave, and I need Herzberger at HQ as a stand-in. You're going to take care of this.
Okay, let's take the Greenhorn for a spin then.
By the way, he's already looked over the report of last Wednesday's accident on the A4. That needs investigating as soon as possible.
So, you're the cadet, huh?
And you must be Chris and Semir.
And we're in a real hurry.
So, are we going?
Yep. You take the patrol car, we'll be in the civilian vehicle.
Use your police light and you should get to the service area before we do.
Do you guys always go at that speed?
Sure, especially when it's important.
So there should be clues to the case we're meant to be investigating right here, at these services?
Nah, but they sell the best coffee here. And because you got here so fast, we've even got time for a second cup.
So why don't you tell us what you know about the accident so far?
Well, according to the lab report, part of the suspension of the right front wheel was broken, which is what caused the accident. They reckon the material wasn't sufficiently solid. It was faulty.
Okay, let's pay a visit to the manufacturer of that suspension and ask him about the quality of his products. Hello there. We're from the Autobahn Patrol. There was a bad accident on the A4 last week. The driver was killed, his son received severe injuries. Part of the wheel suspension you manufactured and sold was faulty, and that's what caused the accident.
There must be some mistake. We'd never sell faulty parts.
The vehicle wasn't very old and it was well kept, so it can't really have been caused by normal wear and tear. Besides, the parts of the other suspensions are just as bad.
In that case, gentlemen, if you'll please accompany me to our testing ground, you'll be able to see for yourselves that we conduct the strictest tests on our parts before they're mass-produced and sold.
What happened to the Greenhorn, by the way?
And what happened to our car?
What do you think you're doing?
Samir, Chris, while you were practicing driving, the production manager you talked to got a phone call. Suddenly, he got all nervous and went off. I thought that looked pretty suspicious, so I followed him.
In our car? On your own?
I'm on him. I'll call you back. Chris, Samir, the suspect has stopped at a cash machine.
Now that's what I call suspicious.
Guess we'll call ourselves a cab.
Thank you.
Chris, Samir, the suspect is driving toward the hospital.
What's so suspicious about someone driving to a cash machine and then to the hospital?
Maybe he's got a relative in there who asked him to bring in some money.
He inquired about the kid who was brought in last Wednesday after the accident on the A4.
You mean the son of the guy in the accident?
I hate to admit it, but that sure does look suspicious.
And if you don't mind me saying so, he just came out, saw us, and now he's getting into the cab in a rush.
So, did the new guy teach you a lesson?
That's why he's got the privilege of writing the report.
What will it say?
The driver who was killed and his wife both worked for the company that produces the wheel suspensions. That's why they had them built into their car.
After the accident, the wife found out one line of products really was faulty. The production manager kept quiet about it. He wanted to avoid the cost of recalling the entire line and save his own job.
She found some documents to prove it and used them to blackmail the production manager.
She wanted the money to look after her son, who it seems is going to be disabled for life thanks to this accident.
I see, and our cadet played a vital part in solving the case.
Nothing but beginner's luck.